Stevie Wonder, written by Maria Isabel Sanchez Vegra. One spring, a little child with a shiny smile was born in Michigan. His name was Stevie, and he became blind a few days after he was born. He wouldn't grow to see the beautiful world around him, but he would feel it and hear it. His family moved to Detroit, and Stevie had to stay home a lot. To help pass the time, he began banging on pots and pans. Soon, he was playing his uncle's harmonica and a neighbor's old piano. When Stevie heard people playing music in the street, he stopped and introduced himself. Clicking his fingers, he joined the party with a joyful voice, while John played the bongos. He was just 11 years old when he signed his first music contract with Motown, a label working with his favorite African-American artists. Everyone was so amazed by his talent that they named him Little Stevie Wonder. As a member of the Motown Revue Tour, Stevie crossed the country in a ramshackle bus, composing songs on the road. He was always the first to go on stage and went to bed straight after his performance. He became the youngest artist ever to top the charts with a tune called Fingertips. Stevie also wrote countless songs about love, peace, and all the things that are worth having in the world. They were full of groove and fun melodies. For years, he had a tutor named Ted who wisely guided him. Ted also had limited eyesight and loved music as much as Stevie did. He wrote a few songs too. One of them ended up being a hit on one of Stevie's albums. When Stevie's first daughter, Aisha, was born, he celebrated with "Isn't She Lovely?", a song made with the pure love of a happy father. You can even hear Stevie bathing his daughter in its closing moments. One day, Stevie was badly hurt in a car accident. He fell asleep for 4 long days and only woke up when his good friend Ira was visiting. When Ira started singing a gospel song, Stevie began to tap his fingers to the beat. Stevie was committed to his community to support those who wanted the birthday of Martin Luther King Jr. to become a national holiday. He created a song. It was so full of joy that people still celebrate birthdays by singing it. From rhythm and blues to soul, from funk to pop, Stevie played everything. He even made the music for a movie and won an Oscar for it. He first recorded "I Just Called to Say I Love You" over the telephone. With 25 Grammy Awards, he is one of the most celebrated artists of all time. Stevie was also named Messenger of Peace by the United Nations and helped improve the lives of people with sensory, mental, and physical conditions. And looking back at all the good friends and great songs he's made through the years, you can tell that little Stevie isn't just an amazing musician, but a person whose joy can be felt by anyone who sings along with him. The end.